You know, I think when you said that there are 10 victims in this case, we know if there are 10, there's probably 30, 40, 50. There could be an upwards of 100
victims. Is that what you're
thinking?
That, all right, there's 10 names, so there's got to be many, many
more.
Put
a zero behind that, and I think that's probably more realistic to what we're looking at in terms of the totality of the impact that he's had on children. Absolutely.
So for these men and children who have come forward, how difficult is this process, what we're doing now, which is, hey, you got to be interviewed by this one. Hey, you've got to give testimony over here. Oh, yeah, by the way, you've got to go inside this courtroom where there's 200 people listening to every word you say.
Yeah. It's so hard. I mean, so I really, the bravery that it takes for these young men to take the stand is, you know, I just applaud
them. Great word, bravery.
Oh, absolutely, because that's what it is. I mean, you're talking about having to explicitly detail one of the most horrifically violating events of your life in front of a live audience, including that of your accuser, who's, you know, looking at you, and you have to engage him at some point. And then you have to endure standing up for yourself. So it's not only the fact that you are a victim, I mean, you've experienced this, but now you've got to defend it by a defense attorney who's going to try to tear apart all of your credibility, rip to shreds the dates, the times, your memory, your recollection. And I think in this case, these victims have done amazingly well. They've been consistent and resolvent.
Yeah. Now, how about the support that they need? What do they need? And this is where sometimes I think our system fails, mm-hmm. In a big way.
Yeah.
In not providing the support. It's getting better. It's getting better. People are understanding it a little bit better, I think, and the resources are there, but there's so much focus on prosecution. But hey, we're prosecuting something because something really bad has happened to someone.
Yeah. I mean, we've moved away from where victims are just a piece of evidence in most cases. In some counties, they're still treated that way. But what we do in victim services is our role is to predict and prepare for that victim. I mean, they've experienced a horrific trauma. And so our role is to ensure that they are not traumatized again by the system, a system that is set up against them. I mean, you've got the defendant who has a litany of rights via the Constitution, and most victims' rights are statutory rights.
Yeah.
So it's, I mean, you're looking at this. There's very little imbalance. So the role of the victim advocate is to really try to push that scale up a little bit and let the victim know every step of the way, this is what you're going to experience, this is what you're going to hear, what you're going to see, who's going to speak with you. And we really walk through the criminal justice system with them so they don't have to be alone.